All right, everybody, welcome. This is another episode of Shooting with Hadja, Hadja Creative. Your favorite, not favorite, but favorite photographer. Here I have the lovely Sophia, who's shot with me a few times. Today is a whole different situation, okay? We are breaching normal limits to what we're out of her comfort zone. Saw the comfort zone, just ran right through the wall. These are gonna be pictures for her significant other. So she wants to get nice and sexy and look nice, like the nice girlfriend, boyfriend, fiance to fiance, husband to wife gift. But here's the thing, this is not what she normally does. So we're pretty much, we start from scratch. We're gonna show her poses. We're gonna make her feel comfortable. I'm gonna walk you guys through the process of working with a model who doesn't do the more sexual style of shooting and how like the pose them, make them feel comfortable and everything to get the best out of them so they're happy with the pictures. Okay? Does that sound good to you? Alright, so we're gonna have you sit on here, but when you sit on here, you're gonna lift your robe up and then sit down so the robe breaks down and doesn't get caught on your butt. Just makes for positioning a lot easier.
Very good.
Alright, so here's a secret some of you may not know when it comes to models sitting down. Especially models who are a little bit more curvier. So what I tell you, when you sit down, one hand, put a cheek out one way, put a cheek out the other way. Because when a model sits down and they're curvy, the butt pancakes, which is not complimentary. Especially if you get a good side shot, and everything looks all nice, and then the butt comes out here and goes, like a flat surface. You're like, my butt really doesn't like that, does it? Then, you know, the nerves get in and everything. So we do that. So now, first thing we're going to do is we're going to work on posture. So what you're going to do is you're going to open your legs up just a little bit. All right? You're going to roll your shoulders back and lift your elbows up. It also gives you a good posture. That's what you want. Have one light in your hair, other light in your side. This will be your main light. I'm going to do a quick little light test. I did one before you got here, but now that you're here, I just want to do another one just to make sure the lighting looks fine. Normally does, but you know, every once in a while, you got to show humility and not be too cocky with your work. Show you guys how beautiful this looks. That's just the first shot. Look at that. See? Smiling and thing. Alright, it's okay. I'm gonna leave that one in there too, just in case you go. I just want the good off, not really playing shot. Alright. So easiest one to do is this leg right here, your left leg. You're gonna bring back this on the two. Good. You're gonna bring your body a little more this way. That hand, gently open the fingers. With that hand, you're going to bring up a little more back. Right there. Good. You're going to look this way, but you're going to lift your chin up. Good. Hold back. So what you want to do when you work with a model, especially one who's never shot before, you're going to kind of look at, you ask them what the person they're shooting for likes, and then you look at them and you figure out nice complimentary shots. And then you let them see what the shots look like so they can get inspired, okay? Because when they see a good shot, like, ooh, yeah, okay, yeah, this is easy. See that look? That's why you do that. You get the nice smile in it. And then you get all happy because it's like, ooh, I look sexy. All right. So we're going to pretty much do all the same thing. We're going to do slight adjustments. Most of these poses are going to be the same with small little adjustments and a little different. This time, you're going to bring your knee all the way in. Your hands are going to be on this side. You're going to look up. That way. Good. And so roll your shoulders back. I'm going to count to three. I'm going to have to take a deep breath in, okay? One, two, three. Good. I'm going to have you do another one. One, two, three. Perfect. Alright. Here's what we add to the degrees of difficulty. Is it like your thigh tattoo?
It was.
Okay. So you gotta ask these questions so you know how to pose. So I'm gonna have you spin yourself over this way. So now what you're gonna do.
See. You're gonna scoot yourself up a little bit more. Good. What you're gonna do is you're gonna put your arms back behind you. I don't know if you guys can see this, but I'm actually doing a pose myself. Because you guys show the models what they look like and it makes them laugh, which is good. So
One leg's gonna be straight, the other leg's gonna be bent. And you're gonna lean your head back. So good. Lean your head back. Right there, I'm gonna get 3 shots of this. Hold your shoulders back a little bit more. Right there.
Good action shot makes everything fun. So I'm gonna have you just flick the rope back and we're gonna catch it as it's fluttering in the air. It's gonna work. Trust me. All right. Are you ready?
Yeah. 1, 2, and 3.
Okay, you gotta be careful how you say stuff like this, okay?
So when you have a nice chest, people tend to slouch with bigger breasts because it's just a little bit more relaxing. So whenever you pose, you have to work yourself out of it and remember to throw it back. It makes the girl stand up, it makes the stomach look flatter, and it gives you this nice shape. And that's what we want. We want to have a nice shape for your pictures.
See that? It almost sounds like I know what I'm talking about, doesn't it?
Alright.
Hold that.
So when you tell someone to put their hands on their chest, be careful on the placement because a nice soft touch like this can easily go into like a boob grab, and depending on what you're shooting, that may not be what the model's going for. So, you know, just things to think about when you're posing people.
All right, hold that.
Expression directions because I want her to get comfortable with the posing first, then from the pose you can go to facials, because facials mean nothing if the pose is not good. So you know you gotta learn how to kind of bide your time and know what to shoot to focus on first. Alright.
So it's been a while since you've been here.
Yeah.
We're gonna work to the basics.
So you never stand straight up. We always want you to pop that hip. You want that attitude.
So with that hand, you can go under the roll, onto the waist. So bring your hand a little bit forward. Right there. Good. That's perfect. Chin up. Slightly chill all the way.
Lift up a little bit more. You're going to look off in the strip. Actually, don't look up. Almost like you're leveling off. Good.
Thank you.
shots.
Oh my god.
See that? When they make that look, you know. What happened here? Alright, so you're gonna bring the rule off your shoulders. That's what we're gonna do. You're gonna kind of cover it in. So what you want is to grab right here. And you're gonna bring it in. So this is a cheat pose. Anytime you have anybody doing anything with their arms close up to their chest, it's to give more cleavage. Especially when you have the right shadowing, it makes things look bigger. But also, it's a little bit of innocent pose, because it's not over-sexualized. It's more like you're covering yourself. I got this pose from people who like wear like do like the big sweater shoots. They bring the sweaters or the coats up when they're cold.
It's the same thing.
Get a sneak peek of the tats. So now here's another trick. If you want to make someone look very, very much more curvier, I'm gonna have you cross your legs. Now, what people don't realize, that's a hard pose to hold. People don't realize that because they see models all the time. Oh, that's not that hard. You try doing the cross-legged hips. All right. Here's where we, this is called when we go in a little bit more in the deep end. See, you just gotta work your way through things. We already had this conversation, but you know. So you're gonna turn around. So we're gonna do what's called a roll throw. This is the classic one. I think I've done this with you once. Drive. I want to show y'all. I'm not going to show her first. I don't want her to see it. Look how that looks. You want to see? Are you sure you want to see? Not that cruel. All right. So we're not going to do a lot. I want when you go for shots like these, even if the girl is very voluptuous, you want to shoot from down up. This just gives everything a better look. So the other one, we have you cross the
hand. That's how I did that to the rock. Here's to watch America next time I hold that. So what you're going to do that, you're going to push your butt out just a little bit more. So the reason why you do this is because the shot right. Like this very great. Bring your hands a little bit down, your head a little bit more right there.
Beautiful. It's just, it's a nice pose. All right, across your legs. So you know how she actually
moves with this. So what I like to do is when I pose models, I wait for them to relax, and then I make adjustments to the relaxed pose so it feels a little bit more natural.
So you're going to be at this level, you're going to bring your right foot back a little bit. And you're just going to push the butt out. Roll the shoulders. Yes. So I'm doing this shot because I want to get this nice little over the shoulder.
Have a little bit of curve peeking into the shot. Really frame it so I can get
the hair and the face,
and just the curve you see from the butt is just like that added bonus, that like nice little peak bonus. And then you just come in closer. Turn this way.
Alright, so here's like the nice little cheek pose. Get your legs shoulder length again. Showing a girl with long hair, utilize the hair in the shot as much as possible because it just adds to the fierceness of the picture.
Close.
Now just look at me. Alright, and the last pose we're gonna do, it's like a bodybuilder pose, but I like it because it just shows off the shape. Your arm you have here, open up a little bit.